Hello, welcome back to anatomy classes. This is Dr. Rachita and we are doing with the osteology of vertebrae. So today's session is the last session on vertebral column osteology, that is we are going to do with the sacrum. So the five sacral vertebrae, all of them joins to form a single triangular like bone called as the sacrum. So the sacrum, it is a wedge shaped bone and its literal meaning is sacred. It is derived from a Latin word which means it's sacred. It forms the lowest part of vertebral column. So the sacrum, here it is in the pelvis. The sacrum, here is the sacrum which articulates on the either side with the hip bone, so to form a joint called as sacroiliac joint. So joint between the ilium and the sacrum is called sacroiliac joint. And it forms a part of pelvis. So if you see the anatomical position of sacrum, it is not straight like this, it is tilted forwards. So the superior surface of the body of the sacrum is tilted forwards, making an angle. The superior surface makes an angle around 30 degrees angle and it is tilted forwards. So that is the anatomical position of sacrum. So if we see sacrum as the whole, it has got the superior surface and the anterior surface. The anterior surface is also called as the pelvic surface, and two lateral surfaces on the either side which is rough, and here is the posterior surface or dorsal surface of the sacrum. Superior surface of the sacrum, it is divided into two parts again. The center part is the body of the first sacral vertebra, which is almost lumbar type, where the transverse diameter is more compared to anterior posterior diameter, and it is huge massive body. And laterally, the lateral masses are called as the ala of the sacrum. So these are the, on the either side, right and left ala of the sacrum. And the anterior border of the superior surface, it projects forwards, which is called as, this projection is called as promontory. It is called as promontory. And posterior to the body, this opening is called as the vertebral canal, which is also called sacral canal. And sacral canal continues and opens down to form the sacral hiatus. So here is the sacral hiatus, which is the continuation of the sacral canal. Let's see the features of the anterior surface or the pelvic surface of the sacrum. So the pelvic surface is smooth. It is smooth in texture, and where we can see the joints between the vertebral bodies. So these are the joints between the vertebral bodies. So the S1, S2, S3, S4, S5. So five sacral bodies joins to form the bone sacrum. On the either side of the body, we can see the foramens, which are called lateral sacral foramens. Lateral sacral nerves passes through the lateral sacral foramens along with the lateral sacral arteries. The median area of the sacrum, it is related to median sacral vessels, and it is related to sympathetic trunks on the either side, and it is related to the peritoneum, pelvic mesocolon and rectum, that is lower two and a half pieces of the sacrum is related to the rectum, and it is also related to superior rectal artery which is supplying the rectum. So these are the structures related to the pelvic surface of sacrum. The ala of the sacrum, it is related to from medial to lateral. It is related to sympathetic chain. It is related to lumbosacral trunk, iliolumbar artery and obturator nerve. So these are the structures related from medial to lateral to the ala of the sacrum. And to remember these things, we can remember the OILS as an abbreviation. O stands for obturator nerve and I stands, O is the most lateral, O is for obturator nerve, I is for iliolumbar artery and L is for lumbosacral trunk and the medial most structure is the sympathetic chain, S for sympathetic chain or sympathetic trunk. So these are the structures related to the ala of the sacrum. Let's see the muscles attached to the pelvic surface. The lateral part of the ala, the rough part of the ala, gives attachment to the rough part of the ala gives attachment to iliacus muscle. And in the pelvic surface, the most prominent muscle which gets origin is ligament. The piriformis gets origin like letter E from the middle three pieces of the sacrum on the either side, which is a most prominent feature of origin on the pelvic surface of the sacrum. And the lower part of the sacrum gives origin to the coccygeus muscle, which is a part of pelvic diaphragm. And let's see the features of dorsal surface. Here is the dorsal surface. The dorsal surface is quite irregular with some projections. So the most median projections are called as sacral spines. So the spines of the sacral vertebra all will join to form the median crest of the sacrum, which is in the center, in the middle. So this is the median crest of the sacrum. And the lateral elevations here, which is called as the lateral crest of the sacrum, which is formed by the fusion of the transverse process. And there is an intermediate crest. Intermediate crest is formed by the fusion of articular processes. That is superior articular process and inferior articular processes all joins to form the intermediate crest. The superior articular process only for the first S1, the superior articular process bears the articular facets which articulates with the inferior articulating facets of lumbar vertebra. So we can see here on the either side superior articulating facets. And the rest of the facets and the process will join to form the intermediate crest over the dorsal surface. The dorsal surface, these crest along the crest and the lateral crest like letter U, we see the origin of erector spinae muscle. So the erector spinae muscle gets origin in the form of letter U. And within the concavity of letter U, multifidus is the muscle, which is a paravertebral muscle, gets origin from the within the concavity of the letter U, means the rest of the sacrum. And lower lateral part of the rough surface on the dorsal side also gives origin to gluteus maximus muscle. Divided by an articular area which is called as auricular process, which appears to be like ear-like. This articular surface, that is auricular process, articulates with the ilium to form sacroiliac joint, which is the most stable synovial joint in the human body. And below, the rest of the lower part below the auricular surface gives origin to two muscles and attachment to two ligaments. You can remember as like two ligaments sandwiched between two muscles. The two muscles are on the dorsally gluteus maximus, on the ventral side coccygeus muscle, and in between these two muscles the ligaments are sacrotuberous ligament and sacrospinous ligaments. So just to remember, two muscles, two ligaments. The two muscles are gluteus maximus and coccygeus, and the ligaments which are sandwiched between them are sacrotuberous ligaments and sacrospinous ligaments. And in front and behind the auricular surface, it gives attachment to the ligaments which are associated with sacroiliac joint, called as dorsal sacroiliac ligaments, ventral sacroiliac ligaments and interosseous sacroiliac ligaments. Dorsal sacroiliac ligaments attached on the dorsal side, ventral side attached along the ala, that is the ventral border, and intermediate is in between. So in between is the interosseous sacroiliac ligaments. Dorsal, on the either side of the median sacral crest, there are dorsal sacral foramina. There are four pairs of dorsal sacral foramina which are present. They communicate with the sacral canal. They communicate with the sacral canal through the intervertebral foramina. and dorsal sacral nerves comes out through the dorsal sacral foramina. And so the structure is coming out through the sacral hiatus. Here is the sacral hiatus where the sacral canal comes out, continues down as the sacral hiatus. So structures coming out of the sacral hiatus are coccygeal nerve and last fifth sacral nerves and phylum terminale, that is the phylum terminale externum, comes out and which attaches to the dorsal surface of coccyx below. So these are the structures coming out through the sacral hiatus. Sexual dimorphism of sacrum, to identify which is male sacrum and which is female sacrum, we can see the male sacrum is narrower and longer and female sacrum is in right hand. This is the female sacrum which is shorter and broader, and male sacrum is longer and narrower. And there is a measurement called sacral index. Sacral index is the breadth at the base by length into 100, that is near the base of the sacrum at the level of promontory, that is the anterior border of the superior surface of the sacrum. If we draw a horizontal line, that is the breadth, and the from the promontory till the lower tip of the sacrum is called as the length. So breadth by length into 100 gives the sacral index, and sacral index is greater in females than in males. It is approximately on an average around 115 in females and 105 in males. And next important measurement is sacrolumbar angle, that is the angle between the lumbar vertebra, the last lumbar vertebra, and the sacrum, which makes an angle. So because the sacrum is tilted forwards, it makes an angle which is called as lumbosacral angle. And this lumbar surface of the fifth lumbar vertebra and the ventral surface of the first cervical, the anterior surface of the fifth lumbar vertebra, which is about to itch, and the ventral surface of the first sacral vertebra, which makes an angle called as lumbosacral angle. It is around 210 degrees, and lumbosacral angle, it is more in females than in males. And if you see the curvature of the sacrum, the curvature, the pelvic curvature is uniform in males. This is a male sacrum, so it is uniform in males. Whereas if we see the female pelvic curvature, the pelvic curvature in females, it is not uniform and it makes a more concavity and makes a turn. So this non-uniformity makes us to identify this as a female sacrum. And the articular surface, here this is the articular surface which forms the sacroiliac joint. It is relatively smaller and occupies upper two segments of sacrum. So here is S1, S2. So it occupies till the level of S2 segments in females. Whereas in male sacrum, the sacroiliac joint, that is the articular surface which forms the sacroiliac joint, it quite bigger and it is relatively longer. It encroaches the third sacral segment. So we can see here, this is S1, S2 and S3. So it is present till the level of S3 in males and it is present till the level of S2 in females. And ratio between the transverse width of the body and the first sacral vertebra and the entire width of the sacral base, it is more than 1/3 in males and it is less than 1/3 in females. So these are some of the differentiating factors to identify which is a male sacrum and which is a female sacrum. I hope these sessions would be very useful for you all to prepare for your practical exams. Please like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon for further notifications. Take care.